We're talking about before, you know, what's fair and what's considered honorable and all that righteousness within the martial arts. I don't have much time for personally, you know. The last guy I remember last year who started some trouble with me, some guy claiming to be from the Navy or whatever, started on me in a bar, and I'd put up with his crap for, you know, some good time. And I just used his neck as an ashtray, straight there. Just pulled a cigarette straight in his neck, opened up like this, and just boom, just smashed him like that. I was sick of it, just like that. And people say, you know, in some cultures or some countries or wherever you go, there's something that's seen to be, how can I put it, not right, not, you know, not...
Fairness, moral.
Yeah, not moral, or not fair, or not, you know, that sort of thing. Like when I get guys come to a seminar and they go, "He just hit me." Like, yeah. And? He was supposed to tell me that, you know, it was coming and I wasn't ready for it and all this other thing. Are you ready for someone to stab you in the back when you're coming out of your car? When you're most susceptible to an attack? When you're most vulnerable to an attack is when you're least expecting it. And that's when the majority of attacks take place. And that's, you know, we've got to be prepared for these things. We can't be in our little comfort zone with our pajamas on and our belts on and our gloves and our mouth guard and our groin guard and our head guard and just suited up, because out there we don't walk around with those things. Some guys, or actually a lot of guys I know on the door, go in protected with groin guards, and some with chest plates and all this sort of thing, or stab proof vests and bulletproof vests and that sort of thing. But again, that can give them a false sense of security sometimes. At times, you know, a lot of these guys are aware too, and they're prepared for things, which is good, and they're taking you know, measures of caution, which are recommended in some areas, of course. But again, with traditional martial arts training, the punch stops here. A lot of the time I train with guys, or have taught guys, that do throws and that, and they punch like this so that you can put them down. And I say, "No, I want you to punch me here, and punch to here, and I want you to punch through my head now. Come on, give me some intent to work with. Otherwise, it's not training. You got to be cruel to be kind, you know." You know, and you see these guys that say, "Oh, I did a combat jiu-jitsu and a combat aikido course, you know, the new course that teaches me how to kill someone with the first technique and break their neck in four places." And there's guys out there on YouTube, "Hi officers, this is for you guys, and when someone pushes you, this is how you fold like the Matrix and break their neck in four ways, and yeah, and if they shoot it, you just catch a bullet with your teeth," and you know, all this stuff that is just ridiculous and unrealistic and requires an understanding of body movement and you know, so much involved in that. But that's why you explain the logic behind things before you start training, to get them mentally prepared. And then physically, they have to have that coordination. And yeah, move out of the way of an attack, and or, you know, jam the attack, or smash the attack, or, you know, force-on-force training. You have to respond to violence proactively a lot of the time to protect yourself or be violent. You know, so a lot of people don't like the fact that we go in with these sort of controls and restraints, and that when I say pain equals compliance and security, a lot of the time it's not pain that's going to inflict grievous bodily harm. It's just some pain that's not going to leave a mark, or it's going to put me on the other side of the law. You know, in law enforcement, when I was giving lectures in Tokyo last time, I said, "What's the difference between you and the bad guys?" I said, "Oh, so many things. They do drugs and they do this." No. What's the difference? You go home at night to your families, they're in jail. What's the difference between that? That can be a simple wrong choice made, you know, and that can be due to some of the training that you've seen or have been taught that is simply not professional nor customized for your job, your specific job. So yeah, that's a lot of the difference between what we do and what traditional martial arts do. Preparing for realistic attacks by throwing people in the deep end, and I just say, "I want you to attack him," and then I'm going to maybe talk to them while the other person's not listening, put them out of the room a lot of the time, say, "I want you to attack them like this with more intent. I want you to go for the neck. I want you to go for under the arms. I want you to grab them, restrain them however you can, put that knife into them. I want to see how they naturally respond." And I'll give them tips on things. When this pressure or this force comes this way, you've not only got to be aware of the knife and your balance and you're protecting yourself, but you've got to do these things, A, B, and C. Depending on the situation, that will dictate your response. So this is the core of what we train. It's martial essence, yes, and that's why it's called raw. But it's also called raw because it's all bullshit aside. You know, none of this, "Are you ready?" You know, and you know, being righteous about it and not kicking them or not punching them in the back of the head or whatever. I do what I want. You know, if someone's going to step to me, like I said to you before, if I have to raise my hands, they're going to be my victim. But I've put up with a lot of shit in the security industry for a long time now and had to deal with a lot of people in my face all like this. And yeah, I can take, you know, people give me shit, I don't mind, but if I have to lift my hands to defend myself or protect myself, the way I like to put it, you know, I'm going to be serious about it, and I am therefore the predator. I'm not going to be the victim who's trying to respond and trying to defend himself. I hate that approach. So all that shit aside, I'm gonna keep it raw.